Hello there. Thank you very much for joining us today in this new Azure Portal how-to video. Today, we learn all about Azure Activity Logs. And for that, we have Anna Furch, who's going to teach us about it. So thank you very much for joining us, Anna.
Yeah, thank you so much for having me. I'm excited to walk you through Activity Log and let you know how to access it and what you can use it for.
Look forward to that.
So Activity Log is really great to tell the who, what, and when for operations in your Azure resources. There's a range of data that you can look at in your Activity Log, from Azure Resource Manager operation logs to updates in your service health events. So there's different ways where you can get to Activity Log. One is by going to All Services over here, and then you can find Activity Log, favorite, and it'll show up in your navigation bar. You can also go to Monitor and select Activity Log from the table of contents on the left, or you could simply go to a resource, such as this VM right here, where you will also find Activity Log in your table of contents. So I'm going to go ahead and click on this. And the advantage of going to a resource and then clicking on Activity Log is that all your filters will already be pre-filtered down to that particular resource. So you can see here, subscription, resource group, and the resource name are already set to this particular VM. If I wanted to change these filters, however, I can easily edit what's already here or click on Add Filter and then select a filter type that I would like, such as operation. And then I can select a particular operation. Let's say create role assignment in this case. Hit that, select, and then it would filter down to only show create role assignment events. If I don't really have time to play around with the filters or I would like to see everything at a quick glance, I could click on this quick insights button, which will open a panel of pre-made filters that are filtered by things like errors, alerts fired, or role assignments even. It'll show you the number of everything that's happened in the past 24 hours too. So I'd like to talk a little bit more about how you can get more out of the events shown in your Activity Log. You can see here on these particular logs, I have an arrow to the left of this. This means that these logs are grouped together by correlation ID and then sorted in chronological order. I can also get some more information out of my logs by editing the columns of this table, which I can do in this top left button, and then by selecting whatever columns I would like to see or would like not to see. Another way I can see more information is by clicking on a particular log, which will open the More Info panel. And this will show me a lot more detail about my log and will even allow me to drill down into the JSON where I can see everything at the most granular level. From this More Info panel, I can also add an Activity Log alert or create a new support request. So Activity Log is really great because it enables you to see your events happening on every resource that you have. So I'm in a VM right now, but I could just as easily be, let's say, in a web app where you can see Activity Log here as well. Or I could also be in a storage account, where again, you can find Activity Log in the same place. Not only that, I can also click on the container that these resources are contained in, and this container itself will also have Activity Logs in its TOC, so in the leftmost panel in the table of contents. And here, instead of having the filters being filtered down to the most granular resource level, I'm only filtered down to the resource group. So I will see all the events that are happening in that resource group to those resources in there as well.
That's really great. And one thing that I noticed is the activity log is always in a consistent location, right?
Exactly.
It's always the second item in every resource type on Azure. So that functionality is available throughout the entire platform, right?
Exactly.
That's great.
Cool.
So thank you very much, Anna, for showing us all of this. It's really great. And thanks every one of you for watching. If you have comments, leave us a comment in the comment section below. Follow us on Twitter and look forward to seeing you in the next video. Thank you very much.